Hello everyone, my name is Vivek and I'm from K4 Metrics. So in my previous video, I had shown you how to import a point cloud data file over a Glyph script. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to import the same file from a Python script. So this is the Python script that I'll be executing to import this mydata.pcd file to Pointwise. So there are two ways. One is to execute the script within Pointwise and import the script, and the other is to import the script by executing the script externally. So to execute the script within Pointwise, make sure you have selected passive mode in the Glyph server menu. Then go back to script, select execute, select the Python script and click open. So since I have two versions of Python, it is asking which version should be used to run the file. So I'll select Python 3. So you can see here that the PointCloud data has been imported. So now I'll show you how to import this file to Pointwise externally. So I'll go to terminal. So I'll navigate to desktop since the file is in desktop. So you can see the Python file here. Now to execute the script externally, so you need to go to Glyph server here and change the mode to active. I'll go back to terminal. I'll type Python 3 and I'll enter the file name. I'll press enter. So you can see here that the PointCloud data file has been imported. So I'll once again create a new blank project. So now you can execute the same script with Thorny also. So the benefit of using Thorny will be you can debug the script. So I'll go to Thorny and I'll open the Python script. So here, instead of simply running, I'll select debug the current script. So here you can use the step over option to see the each process, and you can use step into option to view the sub process as well. Also, if you want to directly go to a certain step, then you can place a cursor, then go to run and run to cursor option. So it will come to this step, and I'll use step over option. So now the script has been executed and you can see that the PointCloud data file has been imported. So this concludes today's tutorial. Stay tuned for more.